Stopping COVID-19 is the Biden-Harris administration's number one priority. Otherwise, the coronavirus will keep circulating in our communities, threatening people's lives and livelihoods, holding our economy back. By helping bring to a close one of the deadliest pandemics in human history, we can show the world once again what American leadership and American ingenuity can do. Let's make that the story of the end of COVID-19.
Our challenges now are two. First, to shorten the lifespan of a borderless pandemic that is destroying lives and livelihoods all over the world. And the second is to ensure that we can prevent, detect, and respond to those future global health threats we know are coming. American leadership is desperately needed, and I'm extremely confident we can rise to the occasion.
This annual report highlights the United States' enduring commitment to making post-conflict communities safer and setting the stage for their recovery and development.
For more than 25 years, the United States has demonstrated its commitment to protecting civilians through support for destruction of at-risk conventional weapons and the clearance of landmines, IEDs, and unexploded ordnance. Over that period, we have provided more than $4 billion in CWD assistance in more than 100 countries.
Throughout the month of April, the State Department is celebrating cultural diplomacy. Cultural exchanges are a powerful way for people to connect across borders and for countries to build respect for each other. Moreover, they're an integral part of U.S. foreign policy. America's arts and culture are a major source of our national strength. Our musicians, filmmakers, artists, writers, and athletes captivate the world.
Working with Congress, we plan to restart the U.S. economic development, security, and humanitarian assistance to the Palestinian people. It includes $75 million in economic and development assistance in the West Bank and Gaza, $10 million for peace-building programs through the U.S. Agency for International Development, or USAID, and $150 million in humanitarian assistance for the UN Relief Works Agency, or UNRWA. The United States is committed to advancing prosperity, security, and freedom for both Israelis and Palestinians in tangible ways in the immediate term, which is important in its own right, of course, but also as a means to advance towards a negotiated two-state solution.
As of today, almost no country on the planet is meeting the target. In fact, if we did everything we said we would do in Paris, the Earth's temperature is still going to rise to about 3.7 degrees or higher. All nations, particularly the developed world nations, the 20 nations that are the equivalent of 81% of all the emissions on the planet, those nations must step up with 2020 to 2030 targets of reduction that keep us within the range of achieving the 1.5 degrees. And then being able to lay out a roadmap taking us to 2050, which is net zero by 2050.
We remember to honor the lives of the 6 million Jews, as well as the Roma and Sinti, Slavs, disabled persons, LGBTQ, and other individuals, and so many others who were murdered by the Nazis and their collaborators. We remember to recognize the innate dignity of those killed and those who survived. And we remember not only what happened, but also how it was allowed to happen. We remember to look at the institutions and societies we're part of, and to understand better what they did and what they did not do. We remember to learn and we learn so that we do not repeat.